swan road. Run up the sail! Who will share a tale?
Some years ago, I took the sea with a sword dancer called Eivor. A brooding warrior with a face of stone and oak-hard arms. On a raid in Courland, we shored up along the... ...and explored until we came to peopled parts. A large farm. It was night, and all were asleep. So we set about plundering the place in the quiet of eve, taking sheep and goats as we pleased. It was then that Eivor saw a farmhand. Pressed the boy for the family's hidden silver. The farmhand squawked like a crow. Being hid beneath an anvil at the smith's forge, the silver was no trouble to lift. In secret, we took it and the boy back to the ship. It was then that Ale grew sad, for when the farmers woke, with the crack of day, they would know they had been robbed, but not by whom. So Ale ordered three of us to follow him back to the sleep-hushed hamlet. As we burnt the houses, Ale shouted his name. I am Ale, son of Skatlagrim, and I am the man who deprives you of everything but your life. I never sail with Ale again.
Cast about this land, my friend.
What's got into you?
Need to cloak myself here.
I'm here to chill the bit, devless, you keen. You know your Freya?
Bring the horn of me, the
mare.
Go, Sunan.
for him.
Let the sail out!
See you!
Generous Lord!
They will attack on sight here.
Thank you.
show me what lies ahead.
When I was 11 winters old, I was the youngest of my favorite cousins. A wild and rowdy bunch of boys and girls. Together with our parents, we attended a feast at the home of Halfdan the Black of the House of Yngling. To toughen our patience, with the old woman, who ordered us to bake flatbreads and serve it to the noble yards. After an hour, the flatbreads piled so high into pillars, you could have built a roof over it, called it a longhouse. When our work was done, an older boy, Uthrod, suggested we steal a keg of mead, and drown in happiness for our good work. So Guthrod, Mikkel, and Orsa snuck into the storeroom and stole the barrel as I stood watch. When we were spotted, I froze. Three of Harald's men stopped us. They struck Guthrod and Mikkel and pushed Orsa to the ground. Whose idea was this? They asked. I stood and said, the idea was mine. The meat is for me. One of the men eyed me and said only, that is not true. Then, they moved on.
What are you doing?
My warning, child!
What do you see?
The last place you visit if you don't! Oh!
Hello there.
Oh. You're not a child.
And you're not a spirit.
No. Just an old man whose son drowned playing near these ruins many years ago.
I'm sorry. That's terrible.
It was. Now I spend my days warding away children from this place, so no other parent must suffer as I did.
I will leave you to it.
Thank you. Be careful on the way down.